Still on COVID, the Presidential Task Force on COVID-19 says the Office of the Accountant General of the Federation has received 792 million naira donations to eradicate the virus. Boss Mustapha, Secretary to the Government of the Federation and PTF Chairman, made this known on Friday in Abuja. He said his office has published the details of inflow into the federal government COVID-19 eradication support accounts, and that as at May the 14th, 792 million naira was credited to the Treasury single account from various sources. Mustapha commended the sacrifices of some ordinary Nigerians, typified by some of the donations, which were as low as 100 naira, meaning that they came from the purest of hearts. And joining us via Skype is Dr. Chima Onoka, who is the Executive Secretary, Christian Medical Dental Association of Nigeria. Good morning, Dr. Onoka.
Good morning, Amaka. Thanks for having me.
Good to have you here. What's your reaction, first of all, to the announcement of more figures in terms of donations coming in to eradicate the COVID-19?
Thank you. It sounds very positive. I mean, that people are still giving, and Nigerians want to give once they have an idea of the platform, and they are seeing the what they are donating that is being recognized, and there's transparency there. So people keep giving, and that's a good sign, because it's a citizen movement, and there has to be that response.
Now, yet another patient has been delivered of a baby boy at Lagos Teaching Hospital, Idiaraba. She's the third patient to deliver safely in Lagos. How reassuring is this for you?
It's really encouraging, because one of those areas that we have a big challenge with is, you know, maternal mortality, and then, you know, deaths also amongst newborns. And we know that the ongoing pandemic and the attention on it has, in quite a number of ways, is affecting the use of other services. And the ones that you're really scared of is, you know, what can happen to maternal and child mortality and newborn mortality. So this is it's a good sign. And, you know, the lessons learned from it are also things that will be translated elsewhere. But that tells us that even the entire system, the health sector across board, there are things that need to be maintained. And especially when it comes to maternal and child health issues, yes.
Right. Now, what's your take on the protest by the academic researchers under the auspices of the Academic Staff Union of Research Institutes against what they allege is their exclusion in the search for a solution to the COVID-19 pandemic in the country?
Yes, you see, I think the group only brought attention to an issue. They added their voice to an issue which has been there. The truth is that research is ignored in the country. It's a problem. It's been a problem for decades. It didn't start today. And, you know, while we can talk about what has happened previously, the important thing will be how we start the investment now. Take the opportunity to start the investment now. So saying what they said is not, whichever way it's looked at, that, you know, they've made a point, they've made their point, but they've only voiced out the concerns of so many people as well. Local investment in research in Nigeria has been poor, very, very poor. We have ignored the fact that research investment is an investment that is necessary for nation building. If we need to do anything now, it is to start it. And local researchers are available. They're available in our institutions. We complain about those universities and research institutions simply because they depend on outsiders to fund their research. To fund research in this country, a lot of the research that is funded is from outside the country. No country develops like that. And this is the time for us to look inward and expand on that.
Right. A federal high court sitting in Abuja, Dr. Onoka, has ordered the House of Representatives to maintain status quo on the infectious disease bill, which has passed second reading. What's your quick thought on this also?
Yeah, I think they echoed the feelings of Nigerians and even of the NCDC, because I remember listening to the DG of the NCDC, who made a categorical statement that times like this, when there are a lot of sensitivities, is also not the time to, debate on such a bill that is sensitive. And remember that, this is a bill to strengthen the work of NCDC. There was also an NCDC Act that came into force just, a couple of years back. And it took time, a lot of time. Now, the one about strengthening it is being done like it's an emergency in the midst of a lot of sensitive issues. So I think a lot of attention needs to be paid to our getting the work done, and everybody that is in a position to do that should do that. And, in line with what the court said, I think they should just hang on with it and let's focus on the immediate issues and sort that out. Otherwise, it will look like there's another interest, even if there's none. Nobody knows whether there is, but even if there isn't, it will look like, there's something somebody wants to achieve.
All right. Thank you so very much, Dr. Onoka, for joining us this morning. And please keep safe out there.
Thank you.